Another feature only found in QuickBooks Online Advanced is the managing workflow automation. You use workflows to send reminders to the right people at the right time. With workflows, you can automate common tasks in QuickBooks, like sending payment reminders to customers. You can also send reminders to your team to complete specific tasks, like reviewing open invoices. You set the conditions to tell QuickBooks when to send the reminders and to whom. Whenever the conditions are met, QuickBooks will automatically send out a reminder. Some workflows automatically send reminders to customers so you don't have to. Others send reminders to your team to take a specific action on a task. You can have multiple workflows of the same type working at once. For example, you can have multiple payment received workflows for different sets of customers. Here's how to create a new workflow for your customers or team. To get started, select the Workflows menu, or select the Settings, and then Manage Workflows. Select the Templates tab. QuickBooks has many workflow templates ready for you to create. I want to set up a bank deposit reminder for Barrett. Select Create under the bank deposit reminder under Workflow Templates. You can give the workflow a name or use a default name. I will keep bank deposit reminder for my workflow name. The conditions section determines what activates your reminders. With this template, I only have one option, which is to choose the undeposited funds. Then choose your conditions of less than, greater than, equal to, less than, or equal to, or greater than. I will choose greater than or equal to a specific dollar amount, which I'm going to just keep at zero. Keep in mind, you can set multiple conditions for some workflows. To add more, select Add Condition. All conditions need to be met to start the workflow. In the Actions section, select the actions QuickBooks will take when the conditions are met. This determines what happens after the template activates. Choose who to assign the task to in the For section. This can be assigned to one person. You can send notification to multiple users. Select the Send Email checkbox to send the reminders as emails. On some workflows, you can also select the Send Mobile Notification checkbox to send a push notification to a user through the QuickBooks Online mobile app. Edit the message in the Subject and Message Body sections as needed. The highlighted fields are variables. The variables populate the reminder message with your company or the customer information. To change the variable, enter the number sign, then select the variable you want to use. Our options are either company name or undeposited funds. Any erasing or overwriting the highlighted fields will affect all reminders. When you're done, select Save and Enable to turn on the bank deposit workflow. I will click on My Workflow so you can see our newly created workflow. Under Action, you can edit the task or see any additional notes added. As we've said before, if a workflow notifies one of your team members to take an action on a workflow, QuickBooks will create a task. All tasks appear in the Task menu so your team can manage everything in one place. Let's go to the Task menu to review our active task. Click on the completed task to review any tasks that are finished. I live for a completed task section, and I'm highly disappointed that our team doesn't have any completed tasks yet. Maybe soon. You can also select the Filters button to filter your task by Created by Me, Assigned to, Due Date, Task Related to, and Task Type. click Apply Filters once you're done. I'm going to go back to our active task to create the bank deposit. If you choose the arrow icon, it will show us the undeposited funds balance and allow you to choose the Create Deposit button, which will take you to the bank deposit to complete your task. Once completed, we can go back to our task and now see that it's completed, which makes me happy. All right, now let's go back to the workflows by creating a custom workflow. So let's select the Workflows menu or select Settings with the gear icon and then Manage Workflows. Select the Templates tab. In the Workflow Name field, enter a name for your template. In the arrow dropdown for Choose a Source, select the template type. Your options are Invoice, Bill, Bill Payment, Estimate, Purchase Order, or Statement. In the Do This in QuickBooks section, select the actions QuickBooks will take when the conditions are met. This determines what happens after the template is activated. Under How would you like this action to happen, select the checkboxes to tell QuickBooks how to send the reminder. Then select the corresponding arrow dropdown for options on assigning the reminder. The options that display depend on the type of reminder you select. Keep in mind the highlighted fields in the template are variables. The variables populate the reminder message with your company or the customer information. To change the variable, enter the number sign, then select the variable you want to use, like customer name, company name, or amount. To create a reminder in Task, this creates a new task in the Task menu. You can choose who you want to assign the task to and the name of the task. You can also choose to close the task manually or have QuickBooks close the task for you when the action is taken, like when your invoice or bill is paid. If you want to send a customer email, this will send an email directly to your customer and any email address you add with the CC or BCC option. You can also customize the subject and email message of the template. If you want to send a company email, you can choose to send an email to someone within the company. Define the subject and body or use the defaults. The last one is to send a push notification. This sends a push notification to a user through the QuickBooks Online mobile app. In the When This Happens section, use the arrow dropdowns to select the conditions. Select Add Another Condition to create more conditions. When you're done, select Save and Enable to turn on your workflow.
Thanks for watching my video on QuickBooks Online Advanced. For me to keep making more videos to show you how to get the most from QuickBooks, please subscribe and click on the bell to be notified when these new videos are made. Thanks again.